Security stakeholders have taxed the federal government to commence the implementation of the Police Trust Fund Act. They said the act, which many have described as a step in the right direction, will help bridge the funding gaps for the police, help purchase modern security equipment and solve the challenges of inadequate funding once and for all. They are also asking the federal government to appoint a substantive head to manage the trust fund so that it can commence full operations.
One of the problems we have with Nigerian police force is underfunding. So this is an intervention fund that for the first instance is going to last for 6 years. And so since the bill was signed into law by the president, the Board of Trustees and the Implementation Committee are yet to be established. So the law requires the president to constitute a Board of Trustees. That Board of Trustees has not been constituted. And there's also an Implementation Committee that is supposed to be chaired by the chairman, by the Minister of Police Affairs, which is also yet to be constituted. So the essence of this meeting is actually to bring stakeholders together to discuss the provisions of the law and also the need for the government to ensure that the act takes immediate effect as required by the law. Because we also believe that one of the problems we have had with the Nigerian police force is the issue of funding. And that if this act is trust fund is implemented very well, it will cushion the effect of lack of effective funding, which is generally affecting the police and its personnel. So it's a welcome development that the government, through the president, has signed the act into law. But I think they should go the extra mile by ensuring that the board is constituted and that the fund actually takes off through the appointment of the executive secretary and other members of the board that will make it to work effectively.
There are these differences in terms of security challenges. And that's why they say, okay, governor, bring up your own security fund. You'll be managing it on your own. But since this is a federal government owned, it crosses across all states. And that is why it is made mandatory for everybody in Nigeria to be a contributor. If you look at the law given, that is going to be 0.5% of federation accounts. That is before they remove the derivation money, before they share it according to the sharing formula. They must have removed this one online, first land charge, before they start sharing. And if you look at the one that companies are to contribute, 0.005%. If properly articulated, it will go a long way in solving the security challenges we have.